It's late, but worth the wait. Late at night, but hey, have to deliver the goods, right? That's our job. That's our business, is deliverance. I was able to cite Manjushri today, which is really great. I said, really, my guru is Manjushri. What they call Manjushri, something, Anabuddha or something, eternally young, eternally youthful, Manjushri. And Longchenpa was an appearance of Manjushri. So that's the quality, that's the feel that's my guru. That's what I take after. Manjushri means gentle glory, and uses prajna or insight, wisdom, insight for realization, which is certainly what I do. And I tend to I see myself as like a more like a 12-year-old than 60 years old. In other words, eternally youthful. I don't identify with age or oldness, or I just don't. I'm getting more and more playful as I go along, getting back to how I was when I was, 12. Even made a skateboard movie today, video. It was pretty good. And I geared up. I'm gearing up. Got a backpack. I loaded it up with everything. It was amazing. Everything I got in there, just it all fits. It's just, I'm getting ready for, look out, Brett Novak. Here I come. To draw parallels in your life, draw parallels between what you do in truth. What you do in truth, and just keep drawing parallels. Keep everything is grist for the mill. Everything, you just pour it into the mill of your awareness, and just say, "Yeah, this really reminds me of full stop." And the wow. So, I did a video on skate safeboarding. How to stop your safeboard. Very few, videos or talks about that. I found some on YouTube, but it's, that's. I never knew how to stop a skateboard, actually. But there are a couple ways. And so I practiced them for the first time today and was able to do it. And I made a video that explains how to do it. And this is very similar to full stop and the wow. How do you stop your momentum when you're going too fast? I mean, we love the spiritual path, but we get going on affirmations and we're like, wow, this is just, I completely lost sight of my life. And you say, okay, but what do I do now? I'm going so fast. Well, you got to slow down. You got to slow down. Full stop and the wow. So, once you know how to stop, like your skateboard, right? Already I feel a lot safer by learning how to do this. One of them is just slowing down when you're going pretty slow, but that's still nice to know, isn't it? Yeah, it's real nice. And the other is when you're going faster, which is great to know. But the skateboard is a dangerous thing, whether you're going fast or slow, actually. I hurt myself when I was going like extremely slow. Well, I had a big fall. I'm recovering from it. My knee's still sore. So knowing how to stop, same thing when we're doing the practices, affirmations. How do we stop, full stop in the well? If we become experts at that, then we don't feel afraid. I'll skate anything in terms of spiritually. I'll spiritually skate anything. Everything is skatable spiritually. Any affirmation can make that, because there's confidence. No matter what arises, I can full stop on the wow it. So there's kind of the strong similarity between skateboarding and spiritual path, actually. Although, most skateboarders are not necessarily on the spiritual path. They seem to kind of have a lowbrow camaraderie. It's kind of like, hey, we all, it's kind of like we're all falling, we're all gonna fall, you know, and so we just, you know, just let not let anybody think they're too good because you're gonna fall too, you know. It kind of keeps you feeling life is going to get you one way or the other. You kind of a gallows mentality, sort of. It really, all these falls and bruises and cuts and this stuff is like, wow. So I'm not into that culture at all, skate culture like that, which is okay. But I've never been into any culture, which is also okay. So we're calling upon Manjushri now. This is really extremely profound. Manjushri is the oldest bodhisattva of them all, the primary bodhisattva, the primal bodhisattva. And some say the accounts of Buddha's life, Manjushri was the one that was orchestrating everything in the Buddha's life. And I don't know. Maybe Manjushri's. What can I say? They say if there's a million bodhisattvas, a million enlightened Buddha minds, all paying attention to Manjushri, they say that they would not even comprehend a single step that Manjushri takes. But this is my guru. Call it the inner guru, call it the Holy Spirit. I don't know what you call it. But I have to say that Longchenpa, I've never come across anyone who was able to express our goal in such beautiful way and such amazing way. It's just, he just stands out like a, you know, like a secular prose, like Shakespeare or something. He just stands out, and you can't help but just be amazed by it all. It's like Rodney Mullen doing all these technical freestyle skating tricks, and you just say, what? What? Wow. Longchenpa is just, everything he says is wowish. Everything he says. He just never misses. Like Rodney Mullen never falls. Longchenpa never misses. He never falls. He never. Everything is just completely brilliant and beautiful. And I, you know, again, like Rodney Mullen, I don't know how he does it. Longchenpa, I don't know how he does it. It's just awe-inspiring almost, you know. It's wow-inspiring. You say, is it possible to even think and express with words? Is it possible to, like this? Yeah. How is that possible? How does he do it? It's just almost like a unique capacity that he had. There's many who have written spiritual subjects, but nobody has written like Longchenpa has. Nobody has expressed it like he has. So they say he was an appearance of Manjushri, the Bodhisattva of wisdom. Gentle glory, who is the all-knowing wisdom and insight that clarifies everything. So this is what I've always had an affinity for, is insight and clarity and wisdom as opposed to other paths. So I'm asking Longchenpa, what do I do this afternoon? What do I do? What do I do? What do I do? I said, ah, I've asked you and you didn't answer, huh? Or how come you haven't? I was kind of like say, wondering, What is he going to answer? Usually he answers so fast. So I'm looking at something. And then something truly amazing happened that just left me stunned. And then I ended up doing taping the video instead of doing something else. I was able to interpret it correctly. You just have to experience it for yourself. It's super amazing. And I'm used to miracles. I'm used to a lot, but Longchenpa Manjushri, Manjushri Longchenpa is just super astonishing. But this is very helpful. The more we experience miracles and answers to our prayers, the more this helps our faith. So I'll keep praying. I mean, I tell you this, Manjushri, Longchenpa, Padmasambhava, Jamyang Khyentse Choekyi Lodro, those four, they respond to your requests for clarity and prayer help in such a miraculous way. What has Longchenpa already done for me? So much, actually. And sometimes I get afraid to ask them for anything. I said, they're gonna do something, and it's better than you expect, and it's just like they seem to be capable. There's nothing they're not capable of, and it's like the Holy Spirit. It's that same grace of God. So I'll keep asking here, a lot. They're orchestrating something. So Manjushri has been around from the beginning of spiritual efforts, and certainly since from the very beginning of Buddhism. Manjushri goes way back. He's very Manjushri is very well known in the East, in China, very well known throughout history. From the sudden the Northeast school. Tibetan Buddhism, he's just considered just the greatest, in terms of the tulkus. They all want to say they're incarnations of Manjushri. So this is just an uber heavyweight. And certainly the insights I've been getting from praying to Longchenpa have just been extraordinary. I've been posting these on Facebook and practices of I have absolutely no business with this world, no business whatsoever. I have absolutely no business with this world. That's the one I first started off this morning. There was another one. I'm not gonna struggle to find it. If it comes up, it comes up, because there could be a better one coming up. Never try to remember something spiritually. Just stay in the moment. Just stay, keep staying in the moment. So don't put your mind back searching for some content. Don't do that. That's a no-no. Aren't we looking for some memory of ourself, the true self? Doesn't that take us away from the true self, searching for a memory of it? Of course it does. So if we just stop searching for a memory of it, there it is. The insight was just came to mind that accept that I'm already awakened. Okay, accept I'm already awake. I'm already realized. I've realized the self. It's already happened. And that means that all the efforts that to prevent me from realizing completely failed. Completely failed. A total failure. Total failure. Now this is an extraordinary practice. This is a Manjushri-like practice. To disrespace very little. Because I'm recording to the... Shoot. I'm recording to the computer. Somehow I didn't take the chip. Man, I don't have much disrespace on my computer. That's crazy. Uh-oh. Okay. Well, we'll make this one short. Wow. I'm really running. I'm almost out of space completely. Got 11 gigabytes left on my computer. That's why it's going so slow. I better defragment and see if I can get a little bit something back. I can't free up its space. I don't know what happens. The hard disk just gets, you know how it is with technology. There's problems every which way you look. So this practice of I'm already enlightened, totally enlightened, which means the shock is that, wow, the world didn't stop me. Nothing I've designed, all the design I've put into trying to forget what I am, it all completely failed. Total failure. Right now, it's a complete total failure. So this is what our focus is. Oh my gosh, it all failed. Totally failed. This is the shock we have to absorb. So we're focusing on absorbing the shock that this, all the forgetfulness of what we are, completely failed us. Completely failed us. Total failure. Across the board. And just abide in the shock of this, wow, just complete collapse and failure of all the forgetfulness. And so abide in that practice. So this is what's really important, is this practice, abiding in this practice. I've already succeeded, totally succeeded. I'm totally awake. So no forgetfulness of what I am whatsoever, none. Which means that a complete failure to prevent it, absolute failure to prevent it. Focus on this, the absolute failure to prevent it. And the shock of that, and get used to believing that it's a total failure. You've come to acceptance of it. So this way you come to gradually, you know, you get more and more used to accepting that our attempt to forget what we are is a total failure. And so then this makes it easy for the actual total failure to happen. You're acting as if it's already happened, and so we're getting used to it. This is just, you know, brilliant strategy, meditational strategy, brilliant strategy. This is a Manjushri-like strategy, coming from Manjushri Longchenpa for sure. now. I've never prayed to Manjushri so much, I don't think. So I'm going to pray to Manjushri directly. Wow. I guess this is something that people may be afraid, because the response will be extraordinary. So I said, might be. I said, no, will. The response will be extraordinary. No question about it. Response will be extraordinary. So I have to prepare for that. So you see how this path works is we take success as already happened, and so our practice is our reaction to the success. This is where we meditate in terms of letting it subside, being patient with it. We don't struggle for answers here at all. Just the opposite. We already have the answers. The struggle is in the shock, because we've been trying to prevent answers. But what we say, well, we've already got them. It's too late. The prevention didn't work. It completely failed. And then we have to swallow this complete failure. Okay, so that's what we're working on, that swallowing, this complete failure. And just to come to accept, I completely failed to prevent myself from knowing what myself is. I come, that total failure, total failure, total failure. No rest today, quite tired, but at least we can get this video out. So, we will see how it goes, right? Certainly, skillful means are occurring to me more and more and more and more. Of practice this way, very advanced practicing. So in your practicing and your focus, try to reach something which kind of just makes you speechless and a little nervous, and that brings up a wow, like, this is really audacious, this is really tremendous. I used to do that with golf courses. I try to find, you know, one that was better than better, so that would you step on the golf course and you just say, "Wow, I don't know, can I handle this? This is going to be extraordinary." So I went through a lot of that. I'm not so keen on it right at this moment. I want to focus in on the realization here. We already have it. and put abidance in it. The shock of the failure of our defenses is preventing the abidance, so to speak. We're so maybe we say the shock of the of abidance, that too has already gone. It's already gone. So there's the shock of that already being gone, and that shock is already gone. So there's a shock of that being gone. And you could go back infinite regress on this one, couldn't? Yes, we can. It's like a skateboard trick. If you know the base, all the basics, and then someone comes up with a new trick, to okay, so you kick it this way and you spin it this way and then like that, and you can figure it out if you really know. So these practices, I can do the practices. I say, oh, okay, like that. That's great. It's not difficult for me. I could say, I'm already not coming out of abidance. I'm already not coming out of abidance, and the shock of that. Focus on the shock of that. I'm already not coming out of abidance. Yeah, that worked really well. I'm feeling it. Speaking of feeling it, I reached a low weight today. Wow. So I try not to eat too much today to see if I can keep it going. I mean, once you're on a roll, keep it going. That's great. Except I don't feel so good. Sore muscles here, this strain here, all this stuff. I don't know. It doesn't matter what weight you're at. You know, you're going to be hurting somewhere, right? You got to soldier on. But wow, low weight. That's very cool. I just don't eat much, bulk anything, really, just smoothies. Tonight I had a little leftover chocolate and coconut water, chocolate protein drink, coconut water, sports drink, and then I put in some acai juice. And then a bunch of organic strawberries. So acai juice, organic strawberries. There was blueberries in with that chocolate protein drink. Blueberries, chocolate protein drink. Oh, Greek yogurt and coconut water. So Greek yogurt, coconut water, blueberries, chocolate protein drink, acai, and strawberries. And blend that up and just drink it. That's it. Just drink it. Tastes good, yeah. And then I had a few white crackers. Just to taste something, you know. It's all okay. I have a few couple crackers. And then I eat walnut pieces, you know, just whatever's around. Walnut, some walnut pieces, a little bit of feta cheese. I think I had a hard-boiled egg and a peanut butter, some piece of bread with some peanut butter on it. But the smoothies, I'm trying to stay with them and just keep stay with it. Very simple. very little food. I mean, that's it. That's what I eat. Let the body, rest from all the food. People eat too much. They eat way too much. If you can actually systematically undereat like what I'm doing now, that's supposed to be extremely good for your health. Okay, so the key is just keep praying, petition, receive, practice, petition, receive, practice, petition, receive, practice. So I'll keep praying, but keep petitioning. You can say prayer if you want. Prayer, receive, practice. Pray, receive, practice. Petition, receive, practice. Pray, receive, practice. Practice what you received. So I'm in the shock of not coming out of abidance. That's what I'm focusing on, the shock. I'm not coming out for any reason. So imagine that scenario. Believe it. This is the scenario that you're in. I'm not coming out of abidance for any reason. Nothing is moving me from it. Wow. I'm just completely steady in it. And so it's like I'm watching that, feeling that, and wowing it, saying, wow, that's amazing. What a great way to practice, isn't it? That I'm seeing myself already completely successful, and then just feeling the shock of amazement, like, wow, I'm completely successful. I'm not leaving abidance at all. But I'm kind of like an observer, a witness of it, feeling that, amazement that nothing's rattling me. I'm not moving out of abidance at all. How extraordinary, how shockingly extraordinary. So this is how I see practice right now. So these other videos I'm doing, action videos, more action in them, don't think that those aren't important also. It's very important to free your actions here in the world from convention, from in a non-degenerate way, okay? Non-destructive, non-degenerate way. But just take actions that are feel inspirational and connect them to you, the spiritual practice you're doing. And be creative and be playful. It's really difficult. I mean, it's just so, takes so much focus and nerve and everything to do it, actually. It's overwhelmingly the way of the world to conform, 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 conform to what materialism wants us to conform to. So when you try to do something different, you feel like you have to be very careful not to start getting paranoid and get a persecution complex and stuff, because you can think of all sorts of stuff to do, and yet you feel that you'll get in trouble if you do that. I better not do that. I better not do that. So it's just extremely difficult. You have to sidestep all that and pray, receive, practice, and trust in the Holy Spirit, and whatever you need to do, it will feel okay for you to do it. You see, don't force it. Don't force it. As soon as I start getting in an argument with like some authority figure in my mind about something, I know, back off. I'm not supposed to do that. Back off. That's forcing things, pushing things too much. Just to keep it simple. But just keep doing things that you can just do easily, Like when you're a kid, you didn't need a lot of things, right? Because you could do stuff, everything was significant that you did. You move something over here, it's very significant. You felt the significance of everything. So you didn't need to go to a store to feel significant. You didn't need money to feel significant. Or you didn't need money to feel like you were living in a significant world. Everything was significant. It's very Zen-like, right? I mean, just everything is significant. You can just look at everything and just feel like everything is just, perfect the way it is. Completely profound. But what it really is that you're seeing intrinsic spaciousness as primary. You're feeling intrinsic spaciousness as primary. And within that context, everything looks sacred, completely sacred. And it is. So whatever you do, it's sacred. It's sacred motion, sacred non-motion. You can't miss. You can't lose. It's all sacred. It's all sacred. Now, yeah, it's pretty rough to go a lifetime without realizing this. I remember when I was in the kitchen one time, I had an experience where everything suddenly appeared to be sacred, and I could compose any sort of poetry was just flowed from me with tremendous ease, and it was all extremely profound. All the poetry, everything I was saying was, but haven't had it since, and it's been almost, 50 years, you might say. To go, 50 years without such an experience, that is not easy at all. That is really just brutally difficult, tough. But yet, that's what's happened. But every moment after that, I said, I want to get that. I want to experience that again. I want to have that my constant experience. So, you don't have to generate profundity at all when you have guru vision. Everything is already completely profound. You're not generating any profundity. Okay, this video is very profound, and we're touching upon something so important here. And it's never search for it. Don't search for it. Don't search for it. As soon as we search for it, we won't find it. As long as we're searching for it, we won't find it. We have to believe that we already have it. There's no searcher, no seeker, no seeking, no searching, no seeking, no seeker. Refuse to believe in any of that. Refuse to seek for it. Refuse to seek for it. How could I possibly have to seek for myself? So refuse to seek for it. I've made so much progress today. The mind tends to want to say, wait a minute, I need to go back and I got to avoid that looking backwards. Don't look back. That's a super discipline. Don't look back. Just trust it. Trust it. Doing this is really the fast track. So you just stay in the now. Insights 10 minutes ago. They're 10 minutes ago. Just stay in the now. Okay, very great. Wonderful. Keep it 40 minutes. That's a good frame time frame for this. All right. Very great. That's it.